Hi, everyone. Aaron here for zollotech, and today the Android 11 January 2020 security update has been released for all supported devices. This was a fairly small update on my Pixel 5 that I have here and my Pixel 4 XL, and the update was, this is just a screenshot of when I was updating it, 27.23 megabytes. It's about the same size on both devices. And you can see here's the update here, so it says now we're up to date, and I was able to update it a little bit earlier. Now, this particular update has changed as far as its overall availability to Pixel devices. The Pixel 2 and 2 XL are no longer supported, so now we have the Pixel 3, 3A, 4, 4A, 4A 5G, and 5, and then all the XL variants of that. And you can see all of the build numbers there, and the build numbers vary depending on device just a little bit, but we have the Pixel 5 with the RQ1A.210105.003 build number. And so with those build numbers comes a few new changes and security updates. Now, this update may already be available for your Samsung device. So if you have a Samsung device, you may have this update as well. Or if you have an Android One device, you might have it as well. But right now, it's rolling out to Pixel devices, and you should get it soon if you're not seeing it already. Now, there's some improvements in this particular update, and I'll go through what devices are supported for those improvements. The first one comes for audio for the Pixel 5 specifically. So further tuning and improvements for the volume level of the system sounds has been updated. So if you were having some odd system sounds when a notification comes in, or maybe the ringer rings on the phone, it should be fixed. They should be more consistent and tuned properly. Now, on the Pixel 4a 5G specifically, there's also a fix for the issue causing speaker noise in certain scenarios. So if your phone was buzzing when it was playing out of the speaker on the 4a 5G, that should now be resolved. Now, on the Pixel 4a, 4a 5G, and Pixel 5, there's further improvements for auto brightness with specific lighting conditions. So if you have auto brightness turned on, it should be more accurate now, and not going super bright or super dark. And it should help with battery as well if it's keeping it a little bit lower. Now, there was also some issues with all of the supported Pixel devices from the 3 to the 5 when certain apps would just crash. So maybe you're opening the camera, for example, and the camera app would crash. So maybe you were opening YouTube or maybe Gmail or the camera app or any of those, and they were randomly, intermittently crashing. Well, it appears that this has been patched and Android 11's January update fixes it. Now, the next fix has to do with the sensors inside the phones on all supported devices from the Pixel 3 to the Pixel 5. So there's been improvements to auto rotation response. So maybe you're in Chrome and it's rotating or it's not working properly. It should now work properly. When you go from portrait to landscape, it should rotate as expected. So that should be fixed on all devices. And then the final bug fix has to do with your phone, and that's specific to all devices as well. So it fixes an issue on certain MVNO networks. So instead of using maybe AT&T or T-Mobile or Verizon in the United States, you're using someone else, a third-party carrier basically, that goes through them. It should now work properly and stop you from preventing calls. So your calls should actually go through now. Now, as far as fixes, that's all that's in this update, but there are some security updates as well. There's quite a few of them, so I'll just go through them quickly. But on all supported devices, we have 16 framework security updates, 3 media framework updates, 4 kernel component updates, 1 MediaTek component update, 1 Google Play system update, and then Qualcomm components. There's 7 updates to that for security, and then 10 Qualcomm closed source component updates. So all of these devices get those updates, and you should have a much more secure device. And then we'll have another update next time. We don't have a Pixel feature drop. We had that in December. So maybe we'll have one in a few months now. So as far as this update, I would expect the overall responsiveness, especially with things like auto rotation, to be a little bit better. Just in using it before filming this video, it seems to respond well. It always responded well on my Pixel 5. I really didn't have an issue, but those extra bug fixes are always welcome. As far as overall battery life, it just seems to get better and better on the Pixel 5 XL. And so it's going to depend on how you use your phone. But of course, it will make a big difference on whether or not you're using it a lot. I actually took it off the charger this morning and we're at 91%. So it's actually doing really well. It seems to idle well. So if you don't charge your phone at night, it seems to last fine. So full charge lasts about 4 days with minimal use on this phone, or about a day and a half or a day or so for me. So it's pretty decent battery life for me overall. So let me know how it's going for you. If you've got the update yet, if you haven't, you can always sideload it. And I also linked all of the information in the description. So if you want to check out the update for yourself and see specifically what security updates were fixed, you can see those as well. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.